Senator Jungbauer.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, and members, I guess I have lived through many times when other members of the now majority party were not recognized. I don't believe that that should be happening on either side, but let us try to remember those sorts of things. Members, it is good that we have this discussion because we need, when we pass this bill, which we will, and as one of my friends said, everything that needs to be said has been said, but it hasn't been said by everyone, so we will continue on. We need to be very clear on legislative intent on this, and as I look through Crawford, you know, members, I started out by thinking I got a lot of emails that called this a potential poll tax, but Crawford, they actually looked at that, and they judged it against Harper versus the Virginia Board of Elections, where Harper set up some of the strongest standards in looking at something to determine if indeed it was a poll tax. So under Harper, it says even rational restrictions on the right to vote are invidious if they are unrelated to voter qualifications. Meaning, members, we cannot do anything when we're talking about things that are unrelated to voter qualifications. However, it says even-handed restrictions protecting the integrity and reliability of the electoral process itself satisfy Harper's standards. So I guess for all those people that emailed me in, this is not a poll tax. We are talking about very even-handed issues related to election integrity. You know, it goes on to say that the law should be upheld on a Crawford issue because its overall burden is minimal and justified. So the Indiana law was not a significant increase over the usual voting burdens, and members, we have made certain that we are not increasing or significantly increasing any usual voter burdens. And it says there is no question about the legitimacy or importance of a state's interest in counting only eligible voters' votes. Now, I don't know how many in this chamber have lost an election by a very close vote, but my very first election on election night was 3 votes that I lost by, meaning I had to go through the mandatory hand recount. So I did get to see how people pay attention to their ballots. I got to see those handwritten ballots voting for Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck. And members, I think every vote does indeed need to count, and every vote needs to be legitimate, because after that hand recount, members, I lost the election by 1 vote. So I realize how important a vote is, and I certainly realize how important it is to make sure those votes are legitimate. When I hear these questions about provisional balloting, you know, my simple answer would be, having worked in foreign countries where they take elections seriously and you have to apply long in advance to be certain you're eligible, perhaps we should take it a little more seriously and make sure we're registered in advance so we do not have to cast provisional ballots. Maybe people would take it a little more seriously if they knew that their ballot might have to wait to be checked. So that's one answer, members. We can certainly do it that way. Now, understanding as well, something that seems to be missing here is when you put a question like this on the ballot, you're talking about somebody having to prove who they are in order to vote. We're not going through anything else with this language. Once you prove you are who you are and that you are an eligible voter, you get to vote. We are having to go back later and figure out if there's other ways to go through that proof. So I'm really having a hard time understanding some of these things, because as I think about it, for all those people that are doing it legitimately now, you don't have to do anything different. You don't have to do anything different. You already have had to prove that you were eligible to vote. This just makes sure you're using a type of certain way to prove that. And there's one thing that's kind of a rhetorical question. What Senator Marty talked about homeless veterans, and I'm still trying to grip with that. I want to make sure everybody gets to vote, but I keep remembering that I believe you have to have a place of residency in order to show to vote, so I don't know how we deal with that, but again, that has nothing to do with this bill. We're certainly trying to prove if you're eligible and putting no more burden than our normal types of burdens on that you can vote, and we are trying to take a lot of time to make sure that legislative intent here is well documented so that when it goes to court, which I'm certain there are people will bring it to court, that that court has no problem in understanding every single detail of our intent. And our intent is certainly not to cast people away, not to have people have a higher burden, but to make sure those that legitimately vote do not have their vote cast aside by somebody that is not legitimate.